And at 9:39, it is Water Cooler Wednesday.
Indeed it is. Here today, Danny Bruns from 98.1 The Max, Steve Connolly with 99.3 Guess FM, and Miramichi Golf Course, and our own Todd Demers.
Otherwise known as the A-Team.
I like that. Yes, you are.
All the people you have on this panel, and we're the 18th?
Yes.
You know, it's good company.
Wow, not yeah.
All
much.
The others may be watching. So remember,
they're the A-minus.
I said it for sure. All right, let's get to work here. According to a new study released yesterday, most of us are confused about how to eat healthy. About 8 in 10 people say they found conflicting information about what foods to eat and what not to eat. So, Danny, is this a real problem for some of us?
I think it is the conflicting reports. I read one thing one day, right. Next week, yeah. It's the opposite. But what I do is I just leave everything in moderation. I eat chicken, maybe the only thing I eat a lot more of, just because mm-hmm. my children, that's all they'll eat.
Chicken fingers, specifically.
And broccoli, thank goodness. They love that. So,
wow.
But everything else is pretty much in moderation, whether it's healthy or unhealthy. I think you're going to... If you don't eat too much of anything, you'll be fine.
Mm-hmm. Balance it out.
Balance. Balance diet.
There Life is a balance. The whole thing's a balance.
It means a little less butter on his lobsters.
Oh, that's what that means.
Now, but the thing about this, we are celebrating a big festival downtown, and probably the most unhealthy thing you can eat is pork, they say. It doesn't digest well. It's fat and all that. It's all just common sense. And if you just eat pork, if you just eat fast food, you're probably going to die early. If you just eat vegetables with no protein, you're going to die. And so we get things all the time come across the show prep. Caffeine and coffee is going to kill you if you had more than X amount. Mm-hmm. Or caffeine is going to make you live longer. Mm-hmm. Or a couple of glasses of wine is going to make you live longer.
Right.
Or a couple of glasses of wine are going to kill you. So
right.
I know that when I'm out, if I have a concern, I'm looking for the sodium. I want to try to get as low sodium as possible, maybe lowest of the carbohydrates as possible. And other than that, you're right. Those labels change on a daily basis, just as far as what to believe and what not to believe. Moderation, watch out for the bad stuff. Try to limit that or put that to a minimal.
You know, there was an article I saw yesterday online. The headline was something like, new information about salt that will surprise you. I didn't even click on it because I was like, oh, for crying out loud.
What now?
Yeah, it'll be different tomorrow. All right, well, a Texas teenager probably will not act up in class again after his dad made good on a promise to show up at school if he kept getting in trouble. Well, the boy did. So his dad did. He came and sat beside his 17-year-old son to keep him in line during physics class. Needless to say, it was pretty uncomfortable for the kid. So, was this dad up for Father of the Year?
Was that a little kid, a little selfie in class there? I like that. I think it's a great idea. I think we've hatched something that would be good. Every parent ought to one time a year have to go in, sit with the kid, sit through physics class.
If the kid's doing wrong.
No, every kid. Every kid.
Every kid.
Every kid. One, it's kind of like jury duty. The employer has to give you off. You have to go in one time. And having a parent in that room is going to keep all the kids pretty much behaving all the time.
Wait a minute. My kid is not misbehaving. I'm not going to embarrass her.
It's part of being a parent, and you have to identify with
that. All right, Todd, how do you feel, Todd?
Well, from what I read, this was a kid who was warned several times. He kept acting up in class that if you keep doing it, we're going to bring your dad. Dad came in, and I think it's great that he did. So, one, he can see, and two, probably embarrass the stew out of the kid to maybe he won't act up. And if you're acting up in class, you're having trouble learning, and so are the others. So, I think it's a great thing that he
Danny, would you do it?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes. I think it's great that he did it. I wish more parents were involved. There's too many cases now where it's not the kid's fault. My little Susie would never do that.
Yeah.
That he
yeah.
went and took care of it. I love it.
Yeah. But don't do it to the good kids.
Every parent.
Do it to everybody, according to Steve.
It's a mandate.
Yes.
Well, I'll send you.
Yeah.
That won't embarrass her because you're a celebrity. Also in Texas, a man has sued his date after she texted during the movie he paid for.
The suit says texting is a violation of the theater's policy, and it adversely affects people's viewing experience. So what do you think about movie theater etiquette these days? Is it needed?
It is. I mean, they already say it. You know, you're not supposed to be on your phones. And here I am. How much you pay now for a movie? 10, 11 bucks. Mm-hmm. And if you've got the family with you and then you buy some popcorn, you're sitting down and you're already, the guy's anywhere going, I just paid 60 bucks for this. And now somebody's over here interrupting my movie experience. I'm furious when something like that happens. Now, whether or not you're going to sue somebody for it, different story. Sounds to me like this is not going to go to a second date for these two people right here. But yes, it bothers me that people still do not. I can understand during the pre-show, you know, and all that. That stuff, knock yourself out. But when the movie starts, anytime you fire up that phone, it lights up the entire place.
Even
and it
if
really
it's
is
in a purse. Don't do it
absolutely.
A purse.
Yes.
We hear I've tried.
We hear about this happening a lot. I've never heard, and I just, because I may not have heard, do movie theaters go in and kick people out for...
I've never seen them do it.
Neither
I haven't either. And I think that would really solve it, because if you've paid that much and you pulled it out and start texting and you got kicked out once, you probably wouldn't do it again. Or bring your dad and make him sit next to you and watch
That's
the movie.
That's a good idea.
Dad, alone at the door, man.
There you go.
Steve Conley?
Cell phone etiquette, whether you're in a movie theater or standing in line at the bank and the guy in back, he's sitting there talking out loud to his girlfriend, whatever it might be, it's just etiquette. And, you know, if you're texting in a movie theater, or talking in a movie theater on the phone, which we've had, you're rude.
Very rude for sure. All right, one last thing very quickly here. An Australian millionaire made headlines this week telling millennials they'll never own a house if they keep buying avocado toast and $4 coffees.
Obviously an exaggeration to make a point, but many young people have unrealistic lifestyle expectations, Todd.
I think so at times, but they're going to learn very quickly, and I think that's just part of the learning curve. You know, avocado, isn't that really like expensive or something like that?
It's healthy, they say.
Daddy?
I didn't think about this till I read the story, and I think that it may become a problem, but it's going to be a problem for everybody if no one, the next generation, can't buy homes. So maybe we should figure out a way to solve it now.
But whose problem is it?
The last word, Steve.
We're going to put avocado toast on the Miramichi menu next week.
We'll see what happens.
But what do the kids most eat? Burritos and frozen burritos and toast.
Ramen noodles.
All right, guys. Thank you very much. Good to have you.
Sacrifice.
All right.